Kate Hudson feared music aspirations could damage Hollywood career, it'll affect everything. Kate Hudson has always loved making music, but this year, at 45, she released her first studio album. Please subscribe to RZ News for more updates. Speaking to RZ News, Hudson explains that she's always been hesitant to share her music on a more professional level because she'd been told that she can't cross over from the acting. People like saying to me, you know, you can't cross over, it's different when you start with music. It's easier to cross over into acting, she shared. But I became famous very young. Mimicking the advice she'd gotten, she said, you shouldn't cross over into music, because if you fail at that, then you're probably going to, it'll affect everything. She admitted, so, that always made the certain things hesitant for me. While Hudson's first credited role was in 1996, she appeared in an episode of Party of Five. Her breakout role came with 2000's Almost Famous. She played groupie Penny Lane in the film, and her performance earned her a Golden Globe Award for Best Supporting Actress as well as an Academy Award nomination in the same category. She's been a household name ever since, with roles in films like How to Lose a Guy in 10 Days and Bride Wars cementing her place in the spotlight. In May, she released her debut album, Glorious, despite those earlier warnings that a crossover into music might not be good for her acting career. When I became really sort of known as an actress young, Hudson said, it was like, you don't become a musician. And I don't think there's a becoming. I think you are born a musician and that's your love or you're not. I remember when Cillian Murphy was on stage, he's like, I was a failed musician. He's like winning one of those awards for Oppenheimer, and I thought, there's no such thing. Like, that doesn't exist. She continued, there's a job as a musician. Like, that's your livelihood. But like, there's no such thing as a failed musician. I don't know why musician is only defined as a job versus a lifestyle, you know. When asked which she likes better, acting or music, Hudson refused to answer, saying, I like to perform. I love all of it. I feel like the luckiest person that I get to do the things that I love the most, she told Fox News Digital. One's not exclusive to the other. For me, truly there's been a void, and it's now filled. She added, I feel like it's made even my acting and my desire to be on set even more fun because I can choose. It sort of feeds each other, I guess, in a way. Hudson worked with her partner, musician Danny Fujikawa, on her album. He CO wrote and CO produced many of the songs. She said that the process of collaborating professionally with him has been amazing, though at first, she was wary of the idea. I didn't think that I would like it, to be honest, she said of working with Fujikawa. When we started, I was like, this will be interesting to see. But because he's not writing for himself as an artist, the facilitating aspect of wanting to make sure I'm happy with the things that I'm hearing, especially as a producer, you know, it kind of removes the ego and allows him to facilitate versus have it be about him. And I think for him and for both of us, it's been really great, she said. Hudson went on to explain that Fujikawa, whom she's been engaged to since 2021, loves to write music and can write for long periods of time on end. Despite the fact that she's been writing songs on her own for years, she can't do the same. I don't have that, she admitted, so to be able to have us or me write something and then have him be able to, like, actually put it down, no matter where we are in the world, it's so wonderful. We have such a great time doing it, you know, so it's really a blessing. In addition to Fujikawa, another artist put the work in to bring Hudson's album to life, legendary singer-songwriter Linda Perry. Hudson said that she, Fujikawa and Perry created what she jokingly called a triangle of sadness to create the album from scratch in a very prolific 2 weeks. In their time together, they created Glorious with enough material left over for an additional album. When I was looking at the curating, she shared, like how the songs would go, it was just so clear that it was a reflection of my life and love and what that looks like, whether it be your kids or past relationships or even like myself, and how others saw me in love, that's really what came out. So far, Hudson has made a few appearances to perform this new music, the first at the Bellwether in Los Angeles in May and the second this month at Webster Hall in New York City. She also did a show at the Surf Lodge in Montauk, New York on July 13, with stars like Gwyneth Paltrow, Jane Krakowski, and Jeremy Piven in attendance.